لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثات بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. A greeting to all with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. We'll continue, inshallah, with reading and translation and understanding the book called Azamat al-Islam, The Greatness of Islam, by Mahmoud Mahdi al-Istanbuli. And today we're talking about the characteristic of the believers, the behavior, the discipline, which is comes as a result of believing in Allah, His attributes and qualities. And the Islam had drawn the line and give us a clear understanding about Allah's attributes. And the Asma of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we believe in them, supposed to be a way of giving us a direction how our behavior as Muslims is supposed to be. Because believing in Allah, believing in His attributes, believing in His names, is supposed to have impact on us. And is supposed to give us a direction. It's not a matter of knowing Allah's names and memorizing them only, but to understand what is behind these names, what is the impact of these names, what is the characteristic of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As example, when you understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a sabur, as example, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most compassionate, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most patient one. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala been abused by a human being? And a human being is not supposed to be abusing Allah. And Allah is capable to destroy them and remove them. Ya ayyuha an-nas antumul al-fuqara'u ila Allah, wallahu al-ghaniyyul hamid. In yasha yudhhibkum wa yati bi khalqin jadid. وما ذلك على الله بعزيز. Allah is telling us, oh mankind, and this is everybody, now as individual, as communities, as societies, superpower, not superpower, Allah is addressing all of us. أنتم الفقراء إلى الله. You are the poor and the most needy to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one self-sufficient, the most rich one. If He will, He will remove you all and bring about another creation. And this is not too mighty for Allah. So although that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has this ability and this capability to remove all people and bring them, bring other creation, He is patient with the people. And the worst thing that a human being is doing, attributing to Allah, is son or a daughter. Saying that Jesus is Son of God, or saying that the angels are the daughters of Allah, or that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the image of a black man, or that Allah is the mother nature, all these things is considered abuse to Allah and curse. Okay? Uh, I forgot what is the word now. Maybe again, Brother Abdullah will give me a hint now. Something abused me. Ibn Adam wa ma kana lahu an. I forgot what is the Arabic word now. Yu'zini. Jazakallah khair. Okay. The son of Adam is disturbing me, is bothering me, is annoying me. Okay? And also in another one, that son of Adam abused me, يَسُبُّ الدَّهْرِ. He curses the time. And I am the time. I am the one who changed the weather, okay? Make it rainy, make it cold, make it hot, and say the bad day and things like this. This is abuse. Says that Allah has a son, this is abuse to Allah. But with this, Allah is what? Still giving them to eat and to drink and health, and Allah is patient with them and giving them opportunity and another chance. They may come back and return and make tawbah and repent and believe. So we learn about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not only that his name is Sabur and this it, but how that this name of Almighty Allah can have some impact, and it will shape our behavior and will make us try to live up to the highest degree of patience and endurance and try to be tyrants. When you learn that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, you see, so all these names and attributes of Allah teaching us something about Allah and how we became enslaving ourselves through the meaning of this attributes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In everything he understands through the whole Quran, all these surahs, starting with exception of one surah, start with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So one of the main characteristics of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the rahmah, is the mercy. To such a degree that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most compassionate, most merciful. He's saying what the meaning is, the Prophet the meaning of Hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala qasam al-rahma ila mi'ata qism, aw mi'ata juz, fa'anzala minha juz'an wahidan, yatarahamu bihi al-nas, hatta al-dawab. Wahtajaz subhanahu wa ta'ala 99 juz'an minha liyawm al-qiyamah. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had divided the mercy into 100 portion, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send only 1 out of 100 for the whole creation to share it. So all what you see, the compassionate, the merciful, a mother to her baby, and even animals, how they caring for their babies, every living thing other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sharing one portion of Allah's mercy. And Allah kept to himself 99 part for the day of judgment. If a kafir know how much is the compassionate and the mercy of Allah, he will never give up hope that he will enter Jannah. You see, the rahmah of Allah is so great that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is still looking to us, giving us a chance to repent, giving us a chance to be better Muslims, to do all the things out of his rahmah. So when we learn the name Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim, what's this supposed to be? That Allah has rahmah, Allah has mercy, and this is it? How we can have rahmah? How that our characteristic and our behavior, that we have tolerance, we have patience, we have mercy, that when you see somebody poor, somebody starving, somebody homeless, all these things, that your heart will go for these people. Doesn't matter if it's Muslim or non-Muslims, even to animals. This woman that was a kafir, she was a prostitute from Bani Israel, okay? But because she saw a dog, not even a human being, a dog, was eating the dirt, because it's so thirsty, So she went down to the well. She fill her khuf or her shoes with water, bring it to the dog to drink. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ash-shakur, the appreciative. He's the one who appreciate. So Allah appreciated what he did, what she did. Look how her life is committing sins. But because one single thing that she did out of rahmah and compassion to a dog. Huh? So we see how is Islam shaping our behavior, our life, by learning the names and the attributes of Allah and to try to live in the light and in the manner of these names. And we can think about all Allah's attributes and all Allah's qualities, and we can try to live them in this manner. When you hear, you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a Sami'. We are not going to go through all the names, but I'm giving you an idea how you shape your behavior, your characteristic, your manner, dealing with people, dealing with yourself, dealing with the community, dealing with Muslims, non-Muslims, according Allah's attributes. Allah is a Sami'. Okay? So you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all hearing. Allah hears. Okay? So now before you understand, start backbiting people, slandering people, you know that Allah wanted to hear this. So now go on to what to change your behavior as a Muslim. You're going to have him back. Let's say, oh, no. Allah will hear this. This is not pleasing to Allah. Okay? So this, when Islam give us the iman and give us the names and the attributes of Allah, so we to try our best to live in the light and in the behavior that fits with the reality and way of these names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As a result of this, we see in one of the verses that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, إنما المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. سورة نمبر 8 فيرس نمبر 2. It seems that there is a mistake in the number here, but we'll check it later. Indeed, the believers are those when Allah's name is mentioned, their hearts get full with fear, and his verses, it will increase them in iman, and they put their trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So again, the verses of Allah, when is recited to us, when we hear about the iman and Allah's attributes, all these things is supposed to bring fear and love to our hearts, to Allah. And it will increase our iman only by knowing about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this will give us the tawakkul and the trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As a result of this, the iman will bring to ourselves the love for Allah. Because the greatness of Allah, because the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because that Allah possesses all good qualities. Because as a human being, you love something good, okay? You get attracted by colors, by beauty, flowers, all these things. Because these things, you understand, it gives a joy to the heart of the person. So when you get to know about Allah and the perfection of Allah and the completion of Allah, all these things make you to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is al-ghani. And when you compare the richness of Allah and the richness of a human being, there is a big difference. Doesn't matter who is this millionaire, billionaire, whatever name it, but they die, they could not even take one single dollar with them. And when they start, when they came to this life, they came with nothing, with no money, with no buildings. So it's a temporary, it's a state, doesn't stay forever. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-ghani al-hamid. And his ghina is part of his essence. That he was not one time poor and after this became rich, and after this he will lose it. And that his righteousness has no extent. Look to this sky that we could not see the beginning or the end of it. Look to all these trees, look to all these things. Look, is not only his position, but the way how he decorated things, the way how organized things, the way how made things look like, okay? It makes you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, some of these things give it to us to eat, some of it to use, some of it only to enjoy, even to enjoy for your feeling, okay? And all these things makes you what? To love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deserve not our love, but the real and the highest level of love that we can reach to. Or our love that we love each other for a physical reason, for material reason, for whatever it is, it goes. But with Allah, you love Allah regardless He gives you or take away from you. Because you know that when He takes it away from you, is for a reason and for protection. There is a meaning, I don't, Allah knows best, they understand how authentic it is, but I'm not attributing it as a hadith, which is saying that some of my slaves, supposed to be hadith Qudsi, but I never get to the bottom to see that authentic, that among my slave servants who are rich, okay? And if I make him poor, he will get spoiled, he'll be corrupted, he's not, could not stand it, he could not function. And some of my slaves, I made them poor, and if I made them rich, he could not maintain. So illness and sickness and power and mighty is in the hands of Allah. So you always praise in him. He gave it to you or take it away from you. Because taking away from you is for your own good. So if the doctor look at you or he cut your stomach, still you understand respect and have this respect to the doctor, because when he cuts you, he's not cut you to make you suffer, but for you to be a better. This is only example. كان ولله المثل الأعلى. Okay? So we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regardless. And look as example to the example of وأما الغلام فكان وأما الغلام فكان أبويه مؤمنين فخشينا أن يرهقهما طغيانا وكفرا فأردنا أن يبدلهما ربهما خيرا منه الزكاة وأقرب رحمة. The story of the Khidr and Musa. When he follow the Khidr and he took a child, little kid, and he killed him. Musa went like, so what's wrong? You a sheikh, you a man, you a good, and say, قتلت نفسا بغير نفس. Did you kill a child? Exists the soul with no reason? But later on he explained to him that his parents love him so much. And this child, if remain alive, he's not going to be a Muslim, he's going to be a kafir. And due to the so much spoiling and so much it is this child, that he will cause their parents to what? To turn to kufr. So will better for them to remain Muslims without a child, better than have a child and to be a kafir. We did not see the wisdom of Allah. We don't see why Allah makes things. So he found the Muslim loves Allah in time of ease and difficulty. And he will say Alhamdulillah, regardless Allah give him or take away from him. Because we know that when he take it away from us, it's for our protection, for our goodness. So we still, our love, it doesn't stop at any time. Not only when he give us, no, when also he take to us, we still say Alhamdulillah, and we be patient. And we be patient. And the reality of this love is not, you understand, like you're going to draw a heart and say, I love you, Allah. You understand, and make a picture and things like this. This is way to accept. But the reality of love in the Islam for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And rushing to do things that he loves. Okay? Again, love to Allah is not going to buy drawing a heart, say, I love you, Allah. And you understand, I'm making a card. And oh, no. The reality of love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you try to be obedient to him as much as you can, and that you always rushing to do things which is pleasing to him. Okay? And saying this will be a form of lie, that you claiming the love of Allah, but you are not loving, but you are not carrying the order of Allah. You claim the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but you are not following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because in the muhibba lil muhibbu muti'u, a person who loves someone, you find him what? He obey. He ready. Yes, what I can do for you. Okay? Yes, my love. Yes, my honey. You understand? So, reality of love to the Creator Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Iman, is the Tawheed, is believing in Him, is submitting to Him, rushing to do what is pleasing to Him, and doing things which is pleasing to Him. And that your love to Allah have to be the utmost of love, not to be equal to anything. Not the equal love in a house, love in a woman, love in a man, life, love in money, okay? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying in Surah number 2, verse 165, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَتَّخِذُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ أَنْدَادًا يُحِبُّونَهُمْ كَحُبِّ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. Among the people who take partners beside Allah, and they love these partners, okay, doesn't matter if they are the angels or Jesus or whosoever, they set a partner beside Allah, and their love to them, okay, is so great, instead of giving the total love to Allah, يُحِبُّونَهُمْ كَحُبِّ اللَّهِ, they love them equal to their love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah saying, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبَّ لِلَّهِ. Those who believe, the true Muslims, their love to Allah will be greater than those kuffar. They set partners to Allah, and their love to their partners more or equal to Allah. What is supposed to be our love to Allah, not like the kuffar and the mushrikeen. Our love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is greater than anything else. As a result of this, we're ready to make the sacrifice. And there is no deen or any ideology will stand without sacrifice. So you want to know how much you dedicated to Islam? See how much you're ready to sacrifice for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How are you going to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you are not willing to learn even about Allah? You are not willing, you understand, to come to a place that Allah had set it with a name to be Baytullah. Not that Allah need a house to dwell in it, but to honor such a place. And he says that this is the best places in the whole earth. Now, if I'm Muslim, they understand, almost everywhere, with exception of the house of Allah. And if they go to the house of Allah, 45 minutes in Jummah, and if the Imam late in the khutbah, a little bit, 5 minutes over, a big thing, okay? We need to fire the Imam, we need to renew an Imam, and so we have to go back to our office. It's no deen, no ideology you're going to establish, regardless if it's good or bad, without a sacrifice. What does it mean, أشد حب لله? I love you, Allah. You're willing to do things for Allah. You need to go extra mile for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Same thing about our love to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay? قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم سورة number 3 verse number 31 say if you really love Allah so follow me why most of the Muslims they different from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم okay because they think the love to the Prophet you come in Rabi and you jump up and down and You make rice pudding and all these cakes and you understand sharing because celebrating the Mawlud and get some songs and this it. But reality of love, try to talk like the Prophet, try to be patient like the Prophet, try you understand to do, to be patient with your wife like the Prophet, try to do everything as much as you can. You are not going to be a Prophet, but you try to set the Prophet a good example for you. Okay? So Allah is showing us the reality of love is to follow. Is to follow. Say, if you really love Allah, so follow me. Allah will love you and forgive for you your sins. Inshallah, we'll try to end this chapter with hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, In the meaning, الحديث ثلاث من كنا فيه وجد بهن حلاوة الإيمان. Three characteristics, if any one of you possess it, will have the sweetness of faith. So there is a faith and there is the sweetness of faith. And this is two different things, okay? Yes, there is Iman. And there is the sweetness of Iman. Is it right, Abu, what's her name? Jannah. That means, you know, like Jannah's mother made to you some curry green or whatever you call it. And after this, okay. And sometimes she spice it a little bit and it's tasty. So there is food and there is something that you tasty. It's tasty food, okay? There is Iman and there is the sweetness of Iman. They are not equal. Okay? You have Iman is good, but you want to enjoy what you're eating. You want to enjoy what you're doing. As a result of this, you find the Sahaba, they can be hurting, but this hurting is giving them sweetness in their heart. Why? Because they have the sweetness of faith. Okay? The sweetness of faith. Alright? Which is something that we need to struggle to get it. Why somebody understand Allah Akbar, Allah Akbar, make Dhuhr in three minutes? Because he doesn't have any kind of communication. As the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam say what? وَجُعِلَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَاةِ Is your color my color? What's going on? You need to get one green, brother. I just noticed it. Please change the color next time, okay?
Do you think let you will... me know. Let me know beforehand. Text me.
Okay, brother. Look at this also. Green soul, brother. What's going on?
Yeah,
Sheikh. Yeah, Sheikh. Oh. What's going on, guy? No. This is a sign of dangerous. You know what this means? Revolution. Somebody going to take over. Even the cameras are getting green now. What's going on? So anyway, so the Prophet ﷺ said what? وَجُعِلَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِ فِي الصَّلَاةِ He loves the perfume, he loves women, but the sweetness and the coolness of his eyes in the salah. Oh brother, this is oud, man. Yeah, man. He knows this about $150 for a small bottle like this. He loves this stuff. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He loves women in halal, okay? He married. But more than any of this enjoyment or perfume of women, he says the coolness of my eyes, the tranquility, I be like, you know, excuse my expression, like say somebody like so high or in spacing out, and he's in another life, in another life, okay? When he's in Salah, this is the utmost of enjoyment in this dunya. Nothing. But how we can reach to this? This is a different level of iman, okay? Some people that has the appetite of sex, appetite of eat food, appetite of this and that. But the real one with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he loves all this, was when he in Salah. Because now, like you, I'm here. Do whatever you want me to do. I'm enjoying. Can we spend more time? Can we talk more? Can we conversate more? Okay? Was when he's in Salah. As a result of this, he used to stand in a long, long prayer until his feet swollen up. But he's not worried about his feet. He's not even feeling the feet. Why? Because the enjoyment that he's in. So here's this hadith, and inshallah, this will come to the end of the chapter to tell you about there is a way how we can not get iman only, said iman, it's shaping us in our behavior, especially about learning Allah, about Allah and His attributes. But the sweetness of faith will come, وَجَدَ بِهِنَّ حَلَوَةِ الْإِيمَانِ, that Allah and the Messenger of Allah will be dearer to you than anything else. If you make the love of Allah and the Messenger of Allah equal, is not going to work. But that Allah and His Messenger أحب إليه مما سواهما, that will be dearer, will be having a higher rank, okay, than anything else. Wife, house, a car, even the Jaguar. Did you sell your Jaguar, sister? Which sister used to drive a Jaguar? Oh yeah, sister Khadija. What is Muhammad? No, I mean your husband. Okay, the second one, which we can maybe we do it, Luqman, we can do a little bit, okay? Said that, أن يحب المرء لا يحبه إلا لله. That you love your Muslim brother, you don't love him for anything other for the sake of Allah. He's not talking the same language. Yeah, we can communicate through English, but somebody talking Swahili and somebody talking Arabic, somebody speaking French and that, but all of us in America speaking English. Doesn't matter what the shape, what different language, everything, what kind of food they eat, but they love each other because when we meet in the masjid, when we conversate about Allah, when you understand that we forgive each other for the sake of Allah, not because he's the boss in the job, I'm scared you're going to fire me. So the love for what? Only for the sake of Allah. Because he's doing the same thing. He's doing da'wah like me. He's, you understand, try to imitate the Prophet like, okay? So you love a person only for the sake of Allah. Love your sister for the sake of Allah. Love your Muslim brother for the sake of Allah, okay? When a sister love another sister, you understand? Not because you understand that she's going to marry her husband, so both of us understand. No, it was not for any reason, all right? Yeah, she tried to get closer, okay, so maybe you understand, I'm thinking to marry your husband. No. Oh, maybe you understand she have a house and she have one apartment empty, she's going to give me a... No, for any selfish reason, not for any dunya reason. A sister love her sister because, yes, she wearing the hamar like her, she studies a class like her. These things make them closer to each other, not for dunya purpose, all right? The last one we say, أن يكره أن يعود إلى الكفر كما يكره أن يلقى في النار. That you will hate to go to disbelief as much you hate to be thrown in hellfire. Can you imagine somebody said, I'm going to throw you in fire? No, please don't do this, you understand? So how much he hates this? He said that you hate the kufr. After Allah snatch you and bless you and get you out of kufr to iman, why are you going back to kufr? Okay? Not they are not gone, but you dislike it the same way you dislike it that somebody to throw you into fire. This man who came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, "O Prophet of Allah, mata sa'at? When is the hour? When is the day of judgment? ماذا أعددت لها? What did you prepare for it? You ready? You're asking about the day of judgment. Are you ready? What did you prepare?" He say, "I didn't have too much salah, too much fasting. Okay? That mean I make only the 5-time prayers. Okay? I give my zakah. I'm doing the basic. So I don't have too much voluntarily action if you're asking about how much indeed do I have. But I have one thing. What it is? That I love Allah and His Messenger." You see, I don't have too much that I can as a credit, but the main thing that here my heart is down with Allah, with the way of Allah, with the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, "You will be with whom you love." Okay? أنت مع من أحبك. So the love of Allah, the love of Deen of Allah, the love of everything that relate to Allah, like learning the Deen of Allah and all these things, is not supposed to be like a homework. Wow, I went last week for a class. Now Sabri's class is Sunday. Oh, and Abdullah Monday. And it's getting too much now. Wallah, some communities they cry and they don't have even one class a month, one class a year. Somebody said, "Brother, but I came to class Monday. Is this okay?" I'm sorry. Because the new sheikh and the new kid in the block, or what do you call it? Okay, I like his class more. It's good, it's fine. But you ate yesterday, you ate the day before, and you're eating tomorrow, and you ate, and you have rice pudding, and you're taking a coffee, and after the... So why would it not say, "Oh, I ate yesterday, I'm not going to eat again. I went to class..." So there is a love for something. We need to love. Love Allah and love things related to Allah. This is the house of Allah. Why sitting in some place and why wouldn't come spend some time in the masjid? So this man, he said, "Oh, Prophet of Allah, I don't have too much salah, too much volunteer prayer, too much volunteer fasting, but I love Allah and I love the Messenger of Allah." So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to him, "You will be with those whom you love." Okay? So let's try to develop some kind of love to the Deen of Allah and love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what He gave us. Love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He blessed us to be Muslims. There's many people walking with no Islam. Let's love Allah for this ni'mah, for this gift that He given to us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us all. Bless our day and make us among those people who act upon what they hear and what they learn. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله and Allah knows best, inshallah. Comments concerning the class. Sorry to prolong it this morning, but we still have 10 minutes for discussion about our meeting tonight, inshallah. Yes.
I have one question. I think I might have missed it.
Yes, you did.
You said the second one was...
I like the color of your shirt. Is this yours or your wife?
No, it's mine.
Okay. Oh, you're matching with the headpiece. Okay.
I don't know.
I'm sorry, Sister Jamila. Your husband is...
I know you had mentioned the second one was the caring for your brother for the sake of Allah and everything like that. And then the third one being...
To hate.
The kufr. Yes. As if you're going to the hell. What was the first one?
The first one?
The first one.
Okay.
I think I missed that.
What was the first one, Ahmed? Oh, by the way, Ahmed remind me a lot about you. I have a lot from you. And his name is Ahmed also. You know this?
No.
Oh, this brother Ahmed here. He's a nice brother, inshallah. And got very young like you also. But his wife is not Jamila. Her name is not Jamila. Mm-hmm. Okay. What's the first one?
When one loves Allah and His Messenger more than anything.
And يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواهما. That Allah and His Messenger be dearer to you more than anything else. You love your Muslim brother for the sake of Allah. You hate to go to hellfire, go back to kufr. You understand the same way that you hate to go to hellfire. You got the three? So it's about, you allow up to four. You can learn more things, you understand, can learn more. Do you understand anything, Sister Jamila? Say no. What, you understood this one? Uh-oh, I'm in trouble, huh? Okay, please come to the class again. Don't make it the last one. Any question? All right, we're going to be closed, inshallah. And after this, we'll discuss a little bit about our meeting, inshallah. For this, we would like to remain. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilaik. Brother Ahmed, you're going to...